Hello friends, what a day it has been. What a wonderful day to have a live session. Indian hockey team, women's team has created history. High point of Tokyo 2020 is our performance in hockey. It's really simply incredible. Jai Hind, Jai Hind, Jai Hind, Jai Hind. Very soon we'll be joined by our guest today, Lieutenant General Satish Dua. We'll be joined by him. But today is an incredible day because of our morning match to beat champions Australia in hockey. Unthinkable. Thank you, Hussain Shah. Thank you. Yeah, today a very senior general is coming on the platform, so I had to be better dressed, you know. Oh, great, great. Great to see you all. Yeah, it's a wonderful day. NCC in NDA, we will talk of it. Today, reserve your questions for General Satish Dua. The moment he comes in, I will invite him. He's got a terrific record. Matlab hum kuch nahi unke aage. General Satish Dua is a role model. Absolutely role model. We have grown up seeing his exploits in various places. So we'll just wait for him to join. But yeah, he's senior to me. Jal Dua is senior to me. We'll just wait for him to join. Sir, Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, Yash, and Jai Hind, everybody.
Sir, what a pleasure. The young people are waiting for you. We already crossed 160, and soon don't be surprised if it surpasses other records, sir.
Thank you. Now we are living in the era of records. Records, yes, are being, sir, broken in Olympics, and very good moments, very enthusiastic moments for India, as well as many other athletes to see.
Especially hockey, sir. अगर कोई 15 दिन पहले कहता कि our teams would be playing semi-finals in Tokyo 2020, लोग कहते पागल है.
True, you are right. It's and both the teams. That's another.
Women's is a revelation. Today's match, sir, perhaps the best hockey match any Indian team has played. So to beat a champion Australia.
We feel so proud. And it's just a coincidence, though these things don't matter so much, but just a coincidence that the women's team or women athletes are doing so well in different fields.
Yes,
and they make us so proud. But I must also share the story. I tweeted about it today on Instagram as well. If some, sir, of you all may have seen it. It's about one of our boxers, Satish Kumar. He's, sir, an army man, and he proved the army spirit today. He lost. He lost 5-0.
I saw that tweet of yours, sir.
Yeah, but imagine, in his previous match,
he 13 had stitches.
Forehead. 13 stitches. Forehead and chin.
Yeah, all stitches.
Yet, and his family, everybody advising him not to take part. But he said he must fight for the country. And imagine, he won the heart. He won the admiration of his opponent, the Ukraine boxer.
Yes, sir.
Uzbek boxer. And when a drop of blood fell on his, he hugged him. Hats off. He didn't win a medal, but he won many hearts.
What a plucky boxer, sir. And you and me have fought boxing in academy and school and all. We understand what it is to be a loser, to get hit and still continue fighting. So there's nothing signifies the spirit of a soldier than boxing, sir.
Yes, so people just take it as a sport, and many other sports and athletic events. What essentially brings out, or it fosters, some very good soldierly qualities in a human being.
Absolutely.
every such sport, especially extreme sports, or even sports like boxing, as we just spoke. These are amazing training grounds to foster that team spirit, camaraderie, and that spirit of being a go-getter.
सर व्हाट आई डू सर, सच अ प्लेजर एंड ऑनर सर, एब्सोल्युटली. हम आपको एडमायर करते रहे सर, जब सेकंड लेफ्टिनेंट थे आप कैप्टन थे सर, तब से हम सोचते थे यार एक कैप्टन सतीश दुआ की तरह होना चाहिए सर, एंड देन वी सॉ यू
थैंक यू मैम,
एज अ लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल एंड देन यू नो चीफ ऑफ द इंटीग्रेटेड डिफेंस स्टाफ. सो आई जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस यू सर, टेक 2 मिनट्स. माई फ्रेंड्स आर वॉचिंग यू, यू हैव अ रोल मॉडल इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. An officer who joined the NDI got commissioned in December 1979 and got commissioned to 8 J&K Light Infantry. उनकी बात करेंगे लाइट इन्फेंट्री. J&K लाइट इन्फेंट्री इज अ कश्मीर बेस्ड रेजिमेंट विद लॉट ऑफ बॉयज फ्रॉम कश्मीर एंड जम्मू रीजन, वन ऑफ द फाइनेस्ट इन्फेंट्री रेजिमेंट्स ऑफ द इंडियन आर्मी एंड इज वेरी प्राउड ऑफ. कुछ जैकलाई का होता है जब दुआ का ट्वीट या इनकी मैसेज जरूर आती है. तो इज बीन अ कर्नल ऑफ द रेजिमेंट. He was the corps commander in 15 corps. We will talk of Udi and surgical strike जितना सर बात करेंगे.
That is a Chinar type.
Yes sir. And the best part is he was a commando instructor. Only the best young officers who get an instructor grading on commando course then get back as an instructor in commando. It is better than going to NDA, IMA, OTA as a captain. The most prized appointment you can go is go back to the commando school and teach. So you are, I think you are an instructor sometimes when people like me did the VAYO course, VAYO 49, December
Yes,
85, 86.
I know you must be carrying very poor memories of me, because commando instructors give a lot of ragda, a lot of punishments, a lot of physical hardships to the students. So you may be
आप
remembering
डिफरेंट है
poor.
सर, बट यू आर नोन एज एन अनप्रडिक्टेबल अनकन्वेंशनल लीडर. इट्स एज अ
Thank you.
कमांडो इंस्ट्रक्टर, मैं बता दूं ये बातें आपको भी, शायद आप भूल गए होंगे सर, बहुत पुरानी होगी. इफ अ टीम लीडर ने अगर अच्छा प्लान दिया विच वॉज अनकन्वेंशनल, विच वॉज अवे फ्रॉम यू नो टेक्स बुक एंड टिपिकल टीचिंग, यू आस्क देम टू ट्राई इट, कि ठीक है कर लो, मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है.
True. It is the we all train our minds to do the right thing. Most of the right things are conventional.
सर
Soldiering is not so calculated. Soldiering is perhaps more to do with the unconventional. Think out of the box. Look at the same thing. All of us look at the same thing. But if you
यस
look at the same thing and think differently, maybe you can come out with some solutions. And
यस
soldiering required all that. So, I mean, I suppose from one has been sort of instinctively encouraging that, and it
नो
has
आई
helped.
आई मस्ट टेल दैट ही कमांडेड इज ब्रिगेड इन इन वैली. He was, he raised a, he commanded a, you know, Assam Rifles headquarter or divisional headquarter in Northeast. He raised it, and in 15 corps in his time, मतलब उड़ी और सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक की बात भी करेंगे, लेकिन जो अमन के लिए जो काम किया इन्होंने, अभी भी बहुत से लोग याद करते हैं. जब कहते हैं कि जब दुआ साहब थे वहां पे ये काम हुआ था, एंड ही ब्रॉट इन लॉट ऑफ यू नो यू आर अ ब्रिज बिटवीन नॉट ओनली द पीपल एंड द आर्मी सर, बट ऑल्सो द पोलिटिकल लीडरशिप. यू आर एबल टू रीच आउट टू देम एज द सीनियर मोस्ट यू नो आर्मी लीडर देयर,
थैंक यू.
एंड यू आर ऑल्सो अ डीए इन वियतनाम सर, वो भी हम बात करेंगे सर. यू आर अ डिफेंस अटैची इन वियतनाम, दैट्स अ वेरी वेरी प्रेस्टिजियस अपॉइंटमेंट. सो यू सॉ दी यू नो साउथ ईस्ट एशिया एंड द डायनेमिक्स ऑफ दैट रीजन वेरी 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 वेल सर.
थैंक यू.
सर विल स्टार्ट विद योर जर्नी फ्रॉम एनडीए सर. मुझे ये विश्वस्त सूत्रों से पता लगा कि यू हैड एक्चुअली क्लियर योर एमबीबीएस सर. आप डॉक्टर बन सकते थे, आप डॉक्टर बन सकते थे, आप एनडीए क्यों गए सर, ये बताएं आप. व्हाई डिड यू ज्वाइन एनडीए?
पहले तो यश, आपको भी पता है हमारे टाइम में इतनी ऑप्शंस नहीं थी जितनी आज कल के जो यूथ जो सुन रहे हैं.
सर
आजकल के यंगस्टर्स को बहुत सारी ऑप्शंस हैं. देर आर सो मेनी फील्ड्स टू चूज फ्रॉम. हमारे टाइम में होता था, या तो आप एनडीए चले जाएं, मेडिकल करें, इंजीनियरिंग करें, और गिनी चुनी दो एक दो ऑप्शंस होती थी, अदरवाइज गेट इनटू. फॉर नॉर्मल ग्रेजुएशन एंड पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन. सो मैं मेरे फादर एयरफोर्स में थे, एनडीए की तरफ रुझान तो था. आई
सर
ऑलवेज दैट इंक्लिनेशन टू ज्वाइन नेशनल डिफेंस अकेडमी. एक बार कपल ऑफ बॉयज फ्रॉम आर स्कूल दे केम बैक ड्यूरिंग द टर्म ब्रेक. एनडीए ज्वाइन कर लिया था, एल्यूमिनाई एल्यूमिना दे
सर
केम बैक एंड दे गेव अ टॉक इन असेंबली. आई रिमेंबर एंड आई वॉज एक प्रबल इच्छा हो गई कि एनडीए ज्वाइन कर. लेकिन मेरे फादर कर्नाटका में पोस्टेड थे जब आई फिनिश माई स्कूलिंग. तो उस वक्त एक मेडिकल कॉलेज की सीट्स होती थी ऑन मेरिट. आई ऑल्सो अप्लाइड फॉर इट. सो आई गॉट एडमिशन इन टू मेडिकल कॉलेज, गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज,
सर
बिफोर आई गॉट द कॉल लेटर फ्रॉम एनडीए. एनडीए यू नो प्रोसीजर फॉर एनडीए आई एम एस सी डी एस इज दैट यू हैव टू गो थ्रू एस एस बी, देन मेडिकल, देन एक मेरिट लिस्ट बनती है. सो इट डजेंट हैपन एज क्विकली. एंड आई गॉट दिस, देन एवरीबडी सेड यू विल बी अ फूल टू पास इट अप, ये है वो है एंड यू नो. सो आई एट 16 17 इयर्स ऑफ एज आई गॉट कैरिड अवे. इट वाज अ स्कॉलरशिप सीट एंड सो आई जॉइंड मेडिकल कॉलेज. आई रियली लाइक्ड इट. इट इज नॉट दैट आई डिड नॉट लाइक इट. आई वाज क्वाइट हैप्पी टू डू डिसेक्शन ऑफ अ कैडी, अ ह्यूमन बॉडी एंड लर्न अबाउट द एनाटॉमी एंड फिजियोलॉजी. दैट्स व्हाट यू लर्न फर्स्ट ईयर. बट सही मायनों में अगर मैं बताऊं तो जब मेरे को कॉल लेटर आया तो मेरे पेरेंट्स ने भी कहा मत जाओ, टीचर्स प्रोफेसर. तो आई ऑलमोस्ट वुड हैव स्टॉप्ड हैड इट नॉट बीन फॉर ए बुक. समबडी गेव मी अ बुक टू रीड, एन
सर
एयरफोर्स इन बीदर वेयर माई फादर वॉज पोस्टेड. ही गेव मी अ बुक ऑन व्हेन ही वॉज पासिंग आउट. इट इज कॉल्ड रीच फॉर द स्काई बाय पॉल ब्रिकहिल. रीच फॉर
ओके
द स्काई बाय पॉल ब्रिकहिल इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ रॉयल एयरफोर्स पायलट ड्यूरिंग वर्ल्ड वॉर, सेकेंड वर्ल्ड वॉर,
सर
हु हैड लॉस्ट बोथ हिज लेग्स इन डिफरेंट एयर क्रैश. सो विद टू वुडन लेग्स ही वॉज स्टिल फ्लाइंग. दोज डेज देयर वाज शॉर्ट ऑफ पायलट, सो दे कंडक्टेड द नेसेसरी फिजिकल टेस्ट एंड हिज नेम वॉज स्क्वाड्रन लीडर डगलस बार्डर. डगलस बार्डर वॉज अ डेयर डेविल फाइटर पायलट इन द रॉयल एयरफोर्स ड्यूरिंग वर्ल्ड वॉर टू विथ टू वुडन लेग्स, वन
ओरे
अबव बिलो द नी वॉज एम्पुटेटेड. नॉट ओनली दिस, लेट मी टेल यू वन मोर थिंग. हिज एयरक्राफ्ट वॉज शॉट इन जर्मनी, ओवर जर्मनी एंड ही बेल्ड आउट. ही वॉज टेकन प्रिजनर ऑफ वॉर. विच एवर पीडब्ल्यू कैंप, पीओडब्ल्यू कैंप ही वॉज प्लेस्ड इन, ही यूज टू एस्केप. इमेजिन ए मैन विथ टू लेग्स वॉज एस्केपिंग. सो एवेंचुअली दे पुट हिम इन श्लॉस एल्बर्ग, द टफेस्ट पीओडब्ल्यू कैंप विच वॉज ऑन टॉप ऑफ अ हिल. एंड देर ही मेड अ ग्लाइडर फ्रॉम पोटेटो ग्लू, विथ यूजिंग पोटेटो ग्लू एंड ही फ्लू आउट ऑफ दैट प्लेस. दो अगेन ही वॉज कॉट, बट इमेजिन द काइंड ऑफ स्पिरिट. सो आई वॉज सो मोटिवेटेड बाई हिज स्टोरी दैट आई वॉज सो कीन टू ज्वाइन एनडीए. एंड वेन आई लुक बैक मैं देखता हूँ कि आई डोंट नो हाउ गुड अ डॉक्टर आई वुड हैव बीन और नॉट, बट आई हैव नेवर रिग्रेटेड इट. दिस लाइफ ऑफ लिविंग ऑन द एज, दिस स्पिरिट ऑफ कमरादरी, दिस टीम स्पिरिट एंड यू नो दिस 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 द काइंड ऑफ स्पिरिट एंड ब्रदरहुड दैट वी लिव इन द आर्मी एंड वी ऑल सर्व द नेशन. डॉक्टर्स डू टू वेरी वेल, बट आई एम वेरी हैप्पी दैट आई हैव नेवर रिग्रेटेड.
योर लाइफ सर अभी भी द अदर डे आई वॉज ट्राइंग टू कॉल यू, आप स्काई डाइविंग के लिए गए हुए थे हिमाचल में सर, देन आई सी यू समडे राइडिंग एंड यू आर टेकिंग द हॉर्स टू द वॉटर, यू नो आई आई सॉ दैट, देन मेरी हेलमेट और मेरी बाइक तो हैशटैग आई हैव सीन योर, आई कैन रिकॉग्नाइज योर बाइक एनीवेयर. आप अभी भी इस एज में भी यू नो लोग बारिश में निकलते नहीं है सर, मैंने साइकिलिंग बारिश में शुरू करी ये यंग लड़कों को बताने के लिए कि बारिश इज द बेस्ट टाइम टू गो फॉर अ रन और गो फॉर साइकिलिंग.
एब्सोल्युटली, ये मेंटल
तो
ब्लॉक बनाने नहीं है.
हाँ बिल्कुल सर, जितना एडवर्स वेदर हो उतना बढ़िया मजा आता है, बर्फ पड़ रही हो तो बाहर चले जाओ यू नो पेट्रोलिंग के लिए, बारिश हो रही है निकल जाओ बाहर.
गुड. मैं जब कारगिल में पोस्टेड था तो आई यूज्ड टू गो फॉर अ रन व्हेन इट वाज द स्नो हैड सॉर्ट ऑफ सॉलिडिफाइड ऑन द रोड्स. एंड उस टाइम अच्छे वाले बूट्स नहीं थे हमारे पास, स्नो बूट्स, अर्ली 90s. दिस इज मच बिफोर द कारगिल वॉर. एंड वन वुड स्लिप एंड फॉल, बट स्टिल इट वाज गुड फन. ट्राई एंड रन एंड वन वुड मैनेज अ लिटिल.
सर ये बताएं सर, इनिशियल इयर्स यू नो NDA and then IMA. Initial years when you joined the unit, where were you and how were your experiences as a young officer, sir? Because ये सब जानना चाहते हैं, as a lieutenant captain, आप में क्या चीज थी, sir, which you know made you where you reached, you know.
Frankly, Yash, and to all those who are seeing and listening, I was a very average officer. I was nothing. It was I was not very outstanding, but I was very enthusiastic. That everyone acknowledges. Energy levels were high, and I think I got commissioned into a great unit, and that really helped. Every human being is hostage to his upbringing.
Yes, sir.
और हमारी upbringing दो जगह पे होती है, either at home and at work. तो
yes.
अभी यूनिट को थोड़ी देर के लिए अगर मैं छोड़ दूं, since I touched upon this topic, so allow me little digression. तो home का पहले लेता हूं और फिर work तो हमारा unit है. मैं I'll come back to the unit जो आपने मेरे सवाल पूछा. But home, my father, as I said, was in the Air Force. My father was an aircraft engine mechanic.
Okay.
He was an NCO when I was a young boy. And I saw, as I started understanding things, that he was so good in his work that his superiors, his engineering officer, trusted him beyond his brief, beyond his mandate. Several times he would not come home in time for a meal or even skip his lunch because he could not find the fault. Now you also understand, everybody understands, say aircraft ke engine mein agar koi fault ho to it cannot be left. Sometimes a very small fault, if it cannot be found, the aircraft will be grounded, it will not fly. Nobody will take that. And the engineering officer has to certify that yes, it is fit in all respects. To do that, he needs to trust his engineers. He needs to trust the people who are. So my father, when everybody would say it is time to go, he would continue to stay. And I remember when he would come late and he would try and tell the story to us. हमें बच्चों इतना समझ नहीं आता था, and I would hear him telling my mother and us that he is the glow of satisfaction on his face that he found the fault where others left home because it was lunch break. He continued to stay, but his satisfaction was more whether he was hungry, but he found the fault. He always chose the harder right over the easier wrong.
Great. I think this is a great lesson, you know.
And I think I have given in one of the Josh talks and in one of the TED talks, I have spoken about this, but I think that made my attitude. And this is a lesson I remembered when I interacted with soldiers when I was commissioned as an officer. And now coming to you know, your upbringing as in work, at work. So our workplace is after we were commissioned in our units. As you brought out, I am from 8th Battalion, the Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry, Jackalai.
Yes,
Jammu and Kashmir Light Infantry. Jackalai Regiment is the only regiment which was not raised as a result of recruitment rallies or recruitment organizations. It was raised, it was a volunteer force which was born in battle. In 1947-48 operations, several volunteer groups sprung up in Jammu and Kashmir, different parts of J&K.
Sir.
And they were, after the war, they were amalgamated into a paramilitary force, or in fact, sorry, middle in during the operation itself, they were amalgamated into a paramilitary force called Jammu and Kashmir Militia.
Yes,
it was only after the 1971 war, seeing their good performance, so that is 25 years later, that they were actually in 1972, they were the J&K Militia was converted to a regular regiment.
Okay.
So, getting back to the story, when I was commissioned into 8th Jackalai, it had very recently become, few years ago, it had become a regiment of the Indian Army. Now, the volunteers that we had, the original volunteers, some of them were illiterate, some of them were because they were volunteers, so they were all taken in. So, but they were very fired up people. Some of them were oldies who had served in World War II. By that time, I got commissioned. They had those World War II kind of people and retired. But we were serving with amongst heroes. My battalion got, as a paramilitary voluntary group, my battalion got one Veer Chakra and two mention and dispatches during 1947 itself.
Okay,
as a fledgling group. In 1971, we got two battle honors. In J&K, we have our battalion in the area of Chum was the only battalion that held on to a piece of land, their defenses, when all others fell back. And we have two battle honors, which is also the theater honors, Lalyali and Pickett 707. No, and we got BRC, Sena Medal, mention and dispatches. So as a paramilitary force, when you have this, and when I was commissioned, we had two VRCs in the unit. Our company commander who spoke pipe and he was a VRC, we listened to his stories, hang on to his every word. My Subedar Major, our Subedar Major was a mention and dispatches, he would tell his stories. So I was raised amongst heroes. When you are raised amongst heroes, your initial upbringing is with such people. On back of what I was as my father's son, with my humility, because my father was also an NCO, or he was then a JCO, in fact, when I was commissioned. So I think this upbringing helped me to shape my attitudes, my connect with the soldiers and with officers up and down. And I think that has shaped my professional personality like nothing, no other factor.
Sir, we share the same. This is really a coincidence that we both retired as general officers from Indian Army. My father was also a soldier in Brigade of the Guards. In fact, when I joined military school, he was a Naib Subedar. I'm from military school, Bangalore. And when I joined the academy, sir, he was Subedar Major. And I joined his regiment. I wore the same uniform and commanded, you know, unit and brigade and all. So, and the way you spoke of your father, sir, same memories I have. My father was an illustrious person, sir. Agar thodi, thodi agar coaching milti, wo, he would have risen to be a general in the army. At least he had all the attributes.
So, aap dekho, when you said you wore the same uniform, how proud your father must have felt.
Yes, sir.
And it is that feeling that really carries us through.
And units are, you know, I know your units are very, very glorious unit. I joined First Guard, sir. And again,
that's
the upbringing.
Very, very, very illustrious unit.
Very illustrious, sir. I wouldn't have been anywhere near where I could achieve in life if it was not.
I used to hear a lot of stories from Jay Menon.
Yes, absolutely. Jay is a very dear friend.
From your battalion, yeah, so we are buddies and we've served together as commando instructors, then in, as general, also in army headquarters, and we've been close.
Yes, sir.
So, yes, I am aware of your battalion and your illustrious battalion and its glorious record.
Yes, sir.
Good to talk to
you. You know, I want to touch upon your command of the unit, sir, and you know, where do you command and how was it, where how challenging it was, sir?
So like I wrote in my book that you were mentioning, because that book of mine, India's Brave Hearts, is all about, or in a majorly it's about my command tenure, because as you know, but let me say it for the benefit of those who are listening. For an infantry officer, it is his ultimate aspiration to command the battalion that he was commissioned in.
Yes.
And what can be better than that is to command your own battalion and lead it into battle.
Yes.
I'm very fortunate that I was blessed with both. In 1998, I became a colonel and I became commanding officer of my battalion.
Sir,
we had just a few weeks ago moved, a few weeks before that, we had just moved to the line of control in Jammu and Kashmir, an operational area where infiltration used to take place. militancy was at its peak those days in 1998. And well, our troops were brave. We had a very young lot because some new battalions were being raised and we had to shed a lot of soldiers. And we had a great run. But the moment I took over and the first encounter that we had, I lost an officer. It was such a blow for the battalion because the first encounter you have, you recently moved in and a new commanding officer and you lose an officer in the first encounter. The morale of the battalion went down. I was feeling very low. The atmosphere was very gloomy. There was no happiness of the fact that we killed all the three terrorists. But, I just couldn't sleep that night. Next, early morning, actually, I realized, and thankfully, that the boys, my soldiers, are looking up to me for leadership. How can I allow myself to be gloomy?
Yes, sir.
So, I collected my men in the morning. Very few are available in when you are in the line of control. And rest be connected through radio sets on post. And I spoke to them. And this is what I said. That yesterday, we lost a brave officer who took a bullet in his chest by leading from the front.
Sir.
And he was a hero because he made sure that no civilians were harmed. And no other soldier was harmed. Nobody got hit because of his brave action, which is true.
Yes.
And what is the best way to pay homage to such a hero? I think the best way to pay homage is not only salutes and doing all the things that we do, but also to carry his mission forward, to ensure that no terrorists remain in our area of responsibility.
Sir.
And I exhorted to them and I told them, exhorted them and said, 10 years ago, when we were in Siachen, we conducted the highest, our battalion executed the highest attack in the world.
At exactly. 21,100. Major Virendra, Major Virendra DRC, sir. Major and Major Only Captain Bana Singh Paramveer Chakra. Absolutely.
He's a living legend, Bana Singh, today. So yes. When we did that, I said during Siachen also, our first casualty was an officer.
Sir.
Our first medal casualty was Second Lieutenant Rajiv Pandey, who got Veer Chakra later, who tied the ropes, was the first casualty. And I said, there also, we went and covered ourselves up in glory after being the first one was a reverse. Similarly, something like that has happened. And thereafter, there was no stopping our boys.
Okay, sir.
Next, operation onwards, our boys were great. It was actually, I had to step on their toes, otherwise they were getting into a lot of audacity. I can talk about that later as to how that came about. But the fact is that I did not realize, I was trying to give them a morale-raising pep talk, but I did not realize that my words would become prophetic, and that's what we did. We accounted for more than 100 terrorists during my tenure of 3 years.
Incredible, sir. I know. And tough terrain, sir. Tough terrain. Not easy to... I have operated in the hinterland in Kashmir, sir, and also Poonch Rajouri sector as a company commander. Hunting these guys is not easy, sir, in that terrain. It really takes a lot of effort, to get after them and, you know, eliminate these, terrorists, sir.
True. I think as good soldiers, once you get caught up in that cycle, you start... You start living, eat, breathe. Everything is about how to be more effective, how to nab them, how to trap them, and that becomes your life.
Sir, रात को सपने वही आते हैं सर. रात को सपने वही आते हैं. मतलब आप रात में अपने आप से यही बात कर रहे होते हो.
Absolutely. Unless you do that, you can't count it.
कहीं firing हो जाए सर, कहीं firing हो जाए, आप सो नहीं सकते हो. I can imagine as a CO. आई बीन इन कॉम्बैट इन मेनी प्लेसेस एज ए कंपनी कमांडर एंड दिस थिंग, आप सो नहीं सकते हो, कहीं गोली चल जाए यू आर अप, एक सेकंड में आप, आपको जो है ना आपके कान खड़े हो जाते हैं।
I once went for 2 days leave. It was Diwali, around Diwali. This was before Diwali. I was back for Diwali in the unit. Diwali to hum jawanon ke saath manayenge. Lekin Diwali se ek aadh hafte pehle ki baat thi. My family was in Jammu. The separated family accommodation, as it is called, it used to be called. So, मैं पहुंचा शाम को घर और चाय पी के बिफोर डिनर आई थिंक आई वॉज लाइंग डाउन रेस्टिंग अ बिट एंड सडनली एक गोली चली. आई जंप्ड आउट ऑफ द बेड एंड यू नो एज इफ आई एम इन एन ऑपरेशन एंड दैट वॉज जस्ट अ नॉर्मल फायर क्रैकर. सो वी आई थिंक वी बिकम ट्रेन्ड लाइक दैट और सॉरी फ्लेक्स स्टार्ट वर्किंग.
Exactly. सर मैं अनंतनाग में था 36 RR में एंड आई गॉट नॉमिनेटेड फॉर माई सेकेंड स्टाफ कोर्स टू ढाका सर. एंड आप मानोगे नहीं, मतलब मतलब इतने दिनों के बाद और सडनली फ्रॉम अनंतनाग दिल्ली कुछ करके 5-6 दिन आई वॉज इन ढाका एंड एनीथिंग वुड हैपन सर, कहीं कोई पटाखा चल जाए, कोई टायर बस्ट हो जाए, कुछ हो जाए, इट टुक लॉन्ग टाइम सर टू कम आउट ऑफ दैट दैट साइकी एंड दैट यू नो. रात को भी यही बातें करनी सर, वही मिलिटेंट नजर आते थे.
True. And Yash, मेरे आप कुछ करियर भी ऐसा रहा है कि I have not commanded a single day in peace. कंपनी मेजर से लेके लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल तक हर कमांड एवरी कमांड अपॉइंटमेंट हैज बीन इन ऑपरेशंस ऑन LC या काउंटर टेररिज्म. Not a single day in peace. And I have, my family has had several bouts of different SF accommodation. But
I can imagine, sir, I can imagine. And
nothing can be more satisfying.
कश्मीर का तो सर आपने शायद कारगिल से लेके नीचे जम्मू सेक्टर तक कोई जगह ऐसी है जो आपने नहीं देखी हो या पैदल नहीं चले हो सर?
नहीं, वैसे तो जम्मू कश्मीर बहुत बड़ा है. But as you say, I have served in the in Ladakh, in Kashmir, in Poonch area, Rajouri area, Jammu area. So I have served in all parts. बहुत बहुत सारे पहाड़ चला हूँ, बहुत सारे one as of course because you know you required to do that, and I'm very fond of walking. Kargil. I have walked over all the posts where later on war took place when I was posted there. Because I was a brigade major and I went to all the posts. I was very fond of doing it. In fact, once as a CO, I wanted to. I was CO in the area of Punjab, just bordering the Pir Punjal. You know that area. So, usme hamare patrols jaate hain, which go across to 15 corps side and they link up with their patrol, jo Pir Punjal patrol hote hain. Wo 3 din ke and we check the Bakrawals also and keep it to dominate the area. Regular patrol hote hain, I think every month in summer. So SEO, I wanted to go, but my brigade commander said, no, you don't go. As commanding officer, you should not go to this patrol. I kept that. Of course, I did not. But later, I became brigade commander of the same brigade.
Oh my God.
And
now you're your own boss.
No, ma'am. I did not go for that patrol, but I had gone to my center in Srinagar with my family. I took 4 days chutti and I went to Srinagar. From there, this is in June 2009, and okay. I was a brigadier, a brigade commander. After that, we had gone to Gulmarg on the last day. I sent my family back by road. I borrowed snow boots from the unit in Gulmarg, tied up with my own unit, and as a brigadier, I walked from Gulmarg.
Next wow. This was
there was about 8 to 10 feet of snow on the higher passes, but there from that side the other came, and I reached there roughly the same time before my family reached.
So this is another coincidence, sir. I must tell you, in January 1988, sir, a very very heavy snowfall, and I was the patrol leader of the brigade patrol with BSF and Dr. Yevo, and I was tasked to cross from Punch to Gulmarg, sir. And
Oh.
that has been the most, in on 1st January we started, sir. I can never forget that patrol of mine, sir, from Sogia, and you've been there. What a
Yeah.
coincidence, sir. We have crossed the same.
Absolutely. No, but you have done it in tougher times. To do it in
I did it
January.
in January, sir, January
Yeah.
88, and snow. There's no route, sir. No GPS,
Right. I can
maps
understand.
unreadable. कुछ पता नहीं था सर कि एंड अनीता एंड ऑल दोस पोस्ट हैव बीन वेकेटेड सर
No, I
एंड तब
understand. You come from Anganpatri and you would have come to Anita and then down towards Sarsu. I can understand how tough it must have been for you because posts get vacated. I have been corps commander on this side. Later on, I have
यस
gone to
सर
the post by helicopter just to see where I was. When it was 10 feet of snow in June, one can imagine in January it must have been very tough. But then maybe you were younger than I was. I was a brigade commander.
I was a two star सर, आई वॉज अ लेफ्टिनेंट एंड मतलब समाव अपनी भी फितरत यही थी क्या टास्क मिल जाए भी देखी जाएगी. आई नेवर लुक बैक सर, नेवर कॉल्ड अप एनीवन कि क्या करेंगे. एंड दिस टीम के साथ इतनी हमने मतलब देयर वाज सच अ लवली बंच ऑफ 20-30 पीपल विद मी. इट वाज ऑल आर्म्स टीम. आई हैड पीपल फ्रॉम बीएसएफ आल्सो. वी जेल्ड सच अ टीम सर. बोले साहब आप देखी जाएगी, अब निकलेंगे, कोई बात नहीं, वापस नहीं मुड़ना, ना किसी से पूछना है. अभी दैट
Good.
वाज रियली अमेजिंग सर.
You see, this is the kind of spirit that gets you everywhere in soldier as a soldier at least.
सर
You see, and you build up a lot of team spirit and camaraderie. This comes in very handy. The spirit of adventure. When we talk of Olympics sports or we talk of any spirit of adventure, a lot of people say, "What is this? Why are you doing this?" And now at this age, why are you doing this? It is the
सर
spirit of adventure that gets you. When I did, like you were on a patrol, but when I went as a brigadier, I was on chutti. And as a
यस
brigadier, I'm not required to walk. As a lieutenant general, when I went, I said, I will, as a corps commander, I said, I'm going to do a skydiving jump. I went and did a jump without formal training. So my point is, when you do such things, the you don't do it with this motive, but it does inspire others. It does
it
inspire.
inspires it certainly. As you as a corps commander, you are so fit. Imagine a three star of Indian Army setting an example. तो आप सोचो लेफ्टिनेंट्स और कैप्टन्स और उनके मन में क्या चलता है यार. ये इज एट 50+. इफ दिस मैन कैन डू, व्हाई शुड वी बी फिट.
True. So that is a very good positive spin-off.
सर
And I think the youth today must understand the value of indulging in any kind of adventure or any kind of passion that you have. It is very important to indulge in a passion. To do that, first you must identify your passion and go for it.
यस
Especially, I don't. I would tell the youth that you must have a passion. And that passion, if nothing else, if it is playing guitar, then play the guitar. Matlab,
यस
do indulge in your passion and nothing like it if you can convert your passion into your profession. Like I did. I was fortunate. Everybody cannot. Maybe your passion is music, but you don't want to make it, or maybe you are not that class that you can become a professional. Then you
Yes,
might
sir.
as well become a doctor or engineer, whatever you are doing, but continue to use that passion as a creative outlet, and you will see the quality of life will improve.
In fact, sir, मैं क्या बोलता हूँ, ये यंग यूथ जो जुड़े हुए हैं, बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स, मैं द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू हैव टू डू इफ यू रियली वांट टू बी समथिंग इन लाइफ, फाइंड कि तुमने कहाँ जाना है, इंट्रोस्पेक्शन का, गो फॉर अ सोलो 10 to 15 डेज ट्रिप. डोंट वरी वेदर यू बॉय और गर्ल. घर से मिनिमम पैसे लो, एक पिट्ठू लो, निकल जाओ. या तो लद्दाख निकल जाओ, या हिमाचल निकल जाओ, या नॉर्थ कहीं भी चले जाओ, सोलो ट्रिप जाओ. यू विल सी इंडिया एंड आपकी एसआरटी क्लियर हो जाएगी, आपके सारे आइडिया क्लियर हो जाएंगे 10-12 दिन. अगर आप अगर घूम सकते हो अकेले, यू कैन
बिल्कुल
ड्रॉप आउट, ऑल लेसन ऑन लीडरशिप यू विल लर्न इन ऑन द ग्राउंड.
एब्सोल्युटली
सर नाउ इट्स सो इंटरेस्टिंग सर ये आपके साथ बात करके. सर थोड़ा सा एवरीबडी सो कीन टू नो अबाउट उड़ी, व्हाट हैपेंड सर, एंड हाउ डिड वी अरेंज दैट सर, इन व्हाट एवर वे यू कैन कन्वे फ्रॉम योर बुक और अदरवाइज. सर एवरीबडी इज वेरी कीन टू नो क्या हुआ उड़ी में, व्हाट वॉज योर रिएक्शन, एंड हाउ डिड वी प्लान द सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक, और व्हाट डिड वी डू सर.
So everybody knows broadly everyone being all about. And if I ask, today we are on an online meeting, but whenever I go and give talks to colleges or some youth gatherings or any gathering, if I were to ask all those who are listening, that when I say Udi, the word, what comes to your mind? The first thing that comes to your mind. I think now that people cannot answer back because of this online medium, otherwise the normal replies that I get, how's the Josh? Because that is something that has been made very popular by that movie and Vicky Kaushal, which is a very which has evoked a very positive patriotic sentiment, and I'm very happy. But when I think of Udi, I don't think of such. For me, what comes to my mind is a dark Sunday, 18th of September, 2015. I'm sorry, 2016. When I was woken up by a phone call that terrorists have attacked our camp at home. There's a bang on the LC. Very good. So, for me, it is the darkest day. I can never live it down. We lost 18 soldiers and it happened on my watch. I lost them when I was leaving. It's something that I cannot live down whenever I think about it. Therefore, for me, when I say Udi, Udi carries that connotation. And I think that was the last. The next day, the army chief came there. The defense minister came. And actually, when the defense minister was coming, I said, why? Why today? I didn't want any more VIP. I was having to deal with the operation. Just the homage ceremony was humongous. I mean, imagine 18 mortal remains and one has to be organizing their flights back home. Everybody's in different districts, making sure it reaches. So many things had to be done, gone into answering the queries of Delhi to politicians, to army, to everyone.
Yes.
So many people were calling up, everybody had right. And the feeling in the heart. So yet the defense minister was there, the army chief was there, the army commander was there. They are also right. So one thing that's the thought that struck me is what good can come out of it. That everybody was there, the leadership was there.
Yes.
That day itself. And the good thing that came out of it was there was a bold leadership which agreed to a plan that I think we always are at the receiving end, because Pakistan sends in terrorists and terrorists come in, they create violence, they carry out their own activities and they go back, and then we are told no, that there is deniability, no, these are terrorists, they are your homegrown terrorists, they are not ours, and things like that. We don't have terrorists to send, how do we do it? So we are always reacting. We are not defensive. So for the first time we decided go reactive. Go
take initiative.
Go preemptive. Go preemptive. And hit only the terrorists. But the difference is that, and in the next 10 days, the amount of training, secrecy, I cannot talk about that, but the kind of operations that were launched, the kind of damage that was done, and for the first time, we went across into their camps at multiple locations, caused damage and came back. But the larger difference, I will state now, and that is why people have wondered that. Why those were surgical strikes and not any other action? There have been actions. I have been a CEO on the line of control. We've done things. But the difference is, unlike Pakistan denies that we have not done things, we, the country, took ownership.
Yes.
Next day, the DGMO comes with, obviously with the consent of with the leadership, approval of the leadership of the country. He comes and holds a press conference and says, I have not only, before he tells the world, he announces to the world, he says, I have already rung up my counterpart in Pakistan and told him, we did it. दिस इज ओनरशिप, नॉट कि हमारे आदमी नहीं थे, हमने नहीं भेजा. वी डिड इट, वी सेड इट, वी डिड इट बिकॉज यू डिड ओडी एंड वी डोंट वॉन्ट टू एस्टिमेट इट एनी फर्दर. नाउ द बॉल इज इन योर. That was, that is why this is
exactly, and the message it went to, it sent shivers down Pakistan army's back, you know.
So the point is, they do realize now the red lines redrawn. If you have another attack, and we showed it after 2.5 years, then another high profile terror attack in Pulwama, then. Precision air strikes.
Yes.
Jabba top near Bala. So today we have at least defined for ourselves a different paradigm. India has shed the soft nation tag, soft state tag, and there are only very few countries, just a couple of countries, which do such, which have done such operations. So I am glad that what has come to known as surgical strike in 2016, the brave officers who executed the strike, I salute them. And once again, I think we can't do anything about the grief and to the families, but we bring some closure to the lost in Udi of that.
Thank you, sir. Really hearing this from you, somebody who, you know, sometimes destiny decides, the course of action which your life will take. And for you, this will always remain the sadness of Udi translating into a national resolve, and filling hearts and minds of millions of Indians with pride. And now, of course, I agree with you. We are no longer the India we used to be, you know. Now, we have shown it with China also, the resolve that Indian army is no pushover. And
whether it was Doklam or Ladakh,
yes, sir,
we have shown it. So when I said, our resolve, like you rightly brought out, so it was not only those two incidents with Pakistan, but whether it was Doklam, it is actually Dolom Plateau, wrongly, that is the Chinese way, is Doklam, and also in Ladakh, to test, they tried to push back, they tried to come in, we stopped them, they did not anticipate the kind of capacity and resolve India has displayed. So, it has sent out a clear message, especially to our neighborhood, and more so, and to the entire world in general.
You're wonderful, sir. Really, we are proud to be part of this great organization, to have served with so much of, elan, and leaving behind such a legacy. So now I'll want to ask you about your book, sir. This is a very well read book, very well received book. A lot of young people write to me when I ask them, "Kya kaun si kitab padh rahe ho?" They say, "Jan Satish Dua ki India's Brave Hearts padh rahe." So when did you get this idea of writing the book, and how satisfying is it, sir?
No, it is very satisfying. I must tell you that I started writing another book, actually, and which is on again Kashmir, which is right now underway, and hopefully by end of this year it should be published. When I was writing that book, I was discussing with the publisher, and I was also telling her that after this, I want to write these stories, and I described to her one or two stories. And she got so keyed up, she said, "No, Chandu, I suggest you write this first." And she actually persuaded me to write that first. In fact, I made a few trips to Kashmir. I started interviewing people. The other book, which I'm finishing now, is on the Ikhwan. That we had, and they turned into soldiers of Jackalai Regiment afterwards,
yes,
as a part of Territorial Army. And Ikhwan, since I've said the word for those who don't, were surrendered terrorists, and we made a force out of them in 90s and in the decade of 2000. So how we utilized them, how, so it is their story. So when she, my publisher, she suggested you write these stories first because they will be very they will catch the imagination of the youth first. And as you will know, these are simple stories about not all are about heroism. Some of them bring out the heroism of some of the soldiers, but not all. They are also about our heartbreak. They are about this reverses we suffered. They are also about how to break news to the family, how tough it is to break the news to the family that your husband and your son is no more. This is about doctors and hospitals. I've written a story about hospital, how a hospital is so active. And of course, it does also contain the story of a surgical strike in some more detail than I've described. All in all, I'd say that since I have written a book, I can't praise it. But the fact is that whatever feedback that I've got, in fact, people have been asking me that when can we see the book in Hindi? And I must tell you that the Hindi translation work is over. I think in a month or two, we will the Hindi. There's a lot of demand for the Hindi translation, so the Hindi version of the same book will also come out.
Wonderful. So in fact, मैं रिकमेंड करने वाला था सर कि हमारे जो हिंदी पढ़ने वाले हैं सर वो कई बार वंचित रह जाते हैं. इतनी अच्छी अच्छी हमारी बुक्स या आर्टिकल्स लिखे आते हैं इंग्लिश पे, बट दिस अ वेरी गुड आइडिया. इनफैक्ट मैं वेरी गुड वेरी हैप्पी टू नो कि हिंदी एडिशन आने वाला है सर.
बहुत सारे लोग बोलते रहे हैं और उसके अलावा मेरे अपने यूनिट के जवान जिनके बारे में ये किताब है तो वो कह रहे हैं सर हम भी तो पढ़ना चाहते हैं. आई थिंक वी ओ इट टू देम एंड आई थिंक इट विल कम आउट होपफुली इट विल बी इक्वली वेल लाइक.
ग्रेट सर, वी लुक फॉरवर्ड टू दैट बुक सर. एंड इन द एंड सर, आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू अबाउट योर एडवेंचर एक्टिविटीज सर. यू नो, हॉर्स राइडिंग, माउंटेन बाइकिंग, स्काई डाइविंग, व्हाट एल्स इज देयर फॉर यू टू एक्सप्लोर सर, एंड वेयर डू यू गेट दिस एनर्जी एट दिस एज?
Nee, what else is there? I'm sure the sky is the limit. There'll be so many things that I have not done. I mean, I really can't sort of try to list that. But yeah. I'm fortunate that God has been kind. Opportunity milti hai tujhe. And rahi baat age ki, age is just a number. It's as you feel that you know. I somehow have this kind of, and I'm sure I'm not the only one. There are so many who have this kind of the spirit of adventure. And like I said earlier, the spirit of your adventure activities fosters so many good qualities in you, and they are a very creative and a very positive outlet for your energies. I think the kind of high you get out of after taking part in an activity and doing it correct is a very great feeling. But yeah. I must also add, when you can't do it, that when you strive that you must do it next time. When my horse does not jump over a particular cliff, I want him to jump. And if he stops, then I have to do it again. And if I fall over his neck, then I must sit down again to make sure that I don't get scared next time. And I must jump. And I have to make the horse jump so that he doesn't get into that bad habit. So that thing that makes you want to do better, at my age, I'm risking myself. Last month, I had one fall and very nearly fell second time. So then you have to be cautious. But the spirit of wanting to do, wanting to clear it and not. So I think on one hand, adventure sports gives you that spirit and that go-getter spirit and the camaraderie and team spirit and so many other things. But on the other hand, it teaches you not to give up. I think that is most important, what you cannot do. And then you're fighting for yourself. If I go cycling or mountain biking, when you cannot finish, when you decide for yourself, I will finish so many kilometers in this many hours. But you suppose you can't do this. And then next time you say, okay, tomorrow, next time I'm going to do it. So you set targets for yourself. And I think that is the best reward that you get. You don't get any medal. You don't get any clapping. There is no audience there. But you feel it, that spirit in yourself.
The joy it gives you is, and the child in you, sir, that comes to the fore. makes you feel young, makes you feel energetic, makes you feel so happy कि आपने I cultivated the started cycling when I got posted to Jodhpur sir, from Leh last year, and I completed 6,000 kilometers in less than a year sir as a novice cycling.
Oh, wow. Very excellent.
And
Excellent, excellent.
now last year on 15th August I did 74 kilometers sir. So let me see if I find somebody have planned to do something like that. So
Great.
the activities, though they and your mind, it's refreshing your mind, sir. You
True.
know, no stress. There is, you're not worried about minor things in life.
It's good to have, your concern should be all about such things rather than into gossip and other things. And today, I think we waste a lot of time on social media, WhatsApp, but it's good to have these outlets.
Someone last question, sir. What would you advise to young boys and girls who want to join the defense forces? What qualities they need to inculcate? What attitude and what habits? If, as a your experience of over 4 decades in uniform, what is that which they need to have, sir, if they want to be officers in the armed forces?
I think I say this to anyone who wants to join. What can tip you can give me? How can you? And I have only one word advice. People with better knowledge can give you a lot of advice. These are the qualities, and they won't be wrong.
Yes.
They would be right. The kind of qualities that you must have: discipline, punctuality, leadership, all that kind of thing. I would like to say that just be true. When I say be true, that means be yourself.
Be yourself.
Just be true to yourself, or be true. When you say be true, that means be yourself. Don't try to fake anything, whether you go for assessment, or whether you are with a group of friends, or whether you are already training in NDA or IMA. Be yourself. कुछ और बनने की कोशिश मत करो. Don't try to be like the other fellow who's doing better than you. Don't try to, yes, strive to do better, but do it better for yourself. Don't try to be or copy anybody. If you can be true, I think everything falls in place. And you will see life is a joy if you just be true. So that means you're never faking it. You're never showing off. You're never wanting to show that you are something else, somebody else. You are what you are. Yes, strive to do better in all fields by yourself. And that will be the new you. I also want to say this to those who try. So those who cannot make it to the army, you are welcome. We need young people like you. But those who cannot make it to army or armed forces, or those who don't want to. Some of you don't want to join because they don't mind serving, they are patriotic, but they don't want to make army their career. Or some have some kind of something that disqualifies them. Maybe classes beyond a certain power or something. So those who cannot join the army or the armed forces, or those who will not, I say, you don't have to join the army to serve the country. You can serve the country by doing what you do to the best of your ability. The growth story of India needs all of you: doctors,
Absolutely.
engineers, carpenters, IT guys, geeks, corporate honchos. Each and every skill set is required to carry the country forward. You are going to drive the growth story of India. So we need all of you. Everyone doesn't have to be a soldier. And if you want to show your respect towards a soldier, then be a good citizen.
Very good.
The sentence is very difficult to follow. It is a very simple sentence. Being a good citizen is not that easy. Be a good citizen. Be a citizen worth dying for.
Oh, wonderful.
Jai Hind.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. What an amazing honor for me personally and for young people to see you live. Thank you so much for sparing your time. So it's been Really a wonderful experience for me, sir, to talk to you. Thank
No,
you,
thank
sir.
you, Yash. Thank you for inviting me. And once again, all the very best to all the young people here. Stay safe in these testing times. Take care. Follow all precautions that are being told in these testing times. And stay safe. Jai Hind.
Jai Hind, sir. Jai Hind.